Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss raster and random scan displays and color CRT monitors. In the previous video we have seen display devices and this display video display devices, and this video display device either it can be a raster display or random display. Right, what do you mean by raster display? In raster display, a picture is formed as a collection of pixels. I repeat, in raster, pixel will be a collection of picture elements. This picture elements is also known as pixels, right? And this picture elements is stored in a portion of a memory known as frame buffer. And in raster scan display, this electron beam sweeps the screen from top to bottom, line by line. From top to bottom, it sweeps the screen line by line. And in which all position the intensity is set on, in that position passphrase starts glowing to give the desired pattern. Right, now we can see what is this horizontal and vertical retrace. See, this electron beam, as I told, it sweeps across the screen from top to bottom line by line. So it will finish the first line, right? From left to right tracing. Again, once the first line is over, it has to start the scanning the next line. So what it will do, from this right end, it will move to this left end and start scanning the second row. And this moving, this retrace is known as horizontal retrace. Once when a line is over, right, this electron beam moves to the next line, right, that is known as horizontal retrace, right? And what do you mean by vertical retrace? In vertical retrace, once the complete screen is over, from top to bottom is over, right, to start the next frame, right, to start the next frame, it has to move to top. This is known as vertical retrace. Once a complete screen is scanned, right, for the next time it has to start from the beginning of my screen. That is known as vertical retrace, right? And this scanning the complete screen once is known as a frame. I repeat, scanning a complete screen once is known as a frame, right? And what do you mean by scan line? Each row is known as scan line. That's what is given. Each row is known as scan line. And what is frame? Right. Once the complete screen is scanned, right, that is known as frame. And this raster scan displays is based upon TV technologies. Right. In the previous video, I told. Right. For a human eye to avoid flickers, short films and all, it has to be refreshed at least 24 frames per second. Right, later they have made to 25 and 30 in United States. That was in earlier time. And today it was, the refreshing rate is 60 to 80 frames per second. Right, 60 to 80 frames per second. And you know, if the refresh rate is less than 24, right, there will be flickering. And you know what is bitmap? We have seen in the last video, that is monochrome color, right? Only one bit is used to represent a pixel. In that case, I'll be having only two colors, black and white, which is known as bitmap. One bit intensity is called bitmap. If I use multiple bits, it is known as pixmap. Bitmap is only one bit for a pixel bitmap. If I use more than one pixel, more than one bit for a pixel, it is known as pixmap. And next is random scan display, right? Raster scan, either my video monitor is can, it can be a random scan display or raster scan display. Raster, random scan means vector display. Vector is nothing but lines. Here, every picture I will be drawing with the help of lines, right? It will be a line drawing. And one more difference between raster and random. In raster, I told this electron beam starts scanning from top to bottom. But here in random scan, right, the electron beam directly focuses on the position where I need to display the image. Right, here, as I told, picture is stored as line drawings, and to avoid flickers, at least I have to refresh 30 times per second. Right, and this refresh rate depends upon the number of lines to be displayed. And this is my raster collection of pixels. This is my random scan display. Right, all my images is drawn with the help of lines. It will be line drawings. And coming to this color display, I have two types: beam penetration method and shadow mask method. Beam penetration method and shadow mask method. And in beam penetration method, this beam penetration method mostly it is used in random display. What is random display? Line drawings. Right, images will be drawn with the help of lines. It will be line drawings. Here in beam penetration method, this CRT, it will this beam penetration method is for color images, right? So if I need color images, I should have color passphrase, right? So I'll have two layers of passphrase. The outer layer is red and the inner layer is green. Right, and the slow electron beam will excite only this red color, and I'll get the red color image. Fast electron beam will penetrate the outer layer, and it excites the green color, so I'll get green color images. Right, if the electron beam, the intensity of my electron beam is between this fast and slow, right, I'll get in between colors, that is mixture of red and green. Either I'll get yellow or orange based upon the intensity of my electron beam. This is my beam penetration method for color images. Next, I have the shadow mask CRT. Again, the shadow mask CRT is also for color images. Between this phosphorus coating and the electron gun, I'll place a shadow mask. This shadow mask is nothing but it is a grid. It will have small holes which allows electron beam. Right. And since I need color, right, I'll have all the color passphrase, primary color passphrase, red, green, and blue. And this primary color passphrase will be arranged in the form of a triad. Right. Triad is nothing but triangle shape, red, green, and blue. Right, passphrase will be arranged as a triads, right? And this red color electron beam will excite only red passphrase. Similarly, other color electron beams will excite their respective color passphrase, right? So when the electron from the electron beam passes through this shadow mask, through this grid, falls on the passphrase coating, excites the corresponding passphrase to get the desired color. Right, this is about your beam penetration and shadow mask. Right, in shadow mask, as I told, based upon the intensity of my electron beam, I can get different colors. Right, simply turning off the red and green guns, I'll get only blue color. Similarly, if I want other colors, I should turn off the respective electron gun. Right, suppose if I turn off only blue, right, and if I have green and red electron guns, I'll get yellow color, mixture of red and green. Similarly, if I have blue and red electron gun, I'll have magenta color. Right, this is how I'll get different colors in shadow mask CRT. So this is all about your color CRT monitor. Thank you.